body?
Oh, there now, I've killed it. I've murdered the tender feeling of comfort stealing over you by sheer tactlessness.
Did you really think I was in love with Sorrel?
I mean, it's difficult to tell, as if you might not know yourself. She is very attractive, you know.
She is? Very.
Oh, it's awful for a woman of my temperament to have a grown-up daughter. I'll have to put my pride in my pocket to teach her all the charming little feminine tricks with men. That would soon cut me out altogether.
That would be impossible.
Do you mean that? Because that would be a sweet remark.
Of course I meant it.
Oh, why don't we sit down? You can tell me all about yourself.
I've done nothing.
Oh, what a shame. Why not?
I never realized how dead I am until I meet people like you. It's rather depressing, you know.
Oh, what nonsense. You're not a bit dead.
Did you always live here?
I intend to from now on. I'm going to sink into a very beautiful old age.
Oh, full of vitality to sink into anything.
It's this furious vitality. If you were to look beneath the surface, you'd see a very wistful and weary spirit.
I'd like to know exactly what you're thinking about.
I'm thinking I should like to call you Richard.
I should be very flattered if you did.
I don't suggest you call me Judith until you feel really comfortable about me.
Oh, but I do. Judith?
I'm awfully glad. Can you give me a cigarette?
Oh, of course.
Oh, what a divine case.
Yes, it was given to me in the Orient. All these little designs mean things, you know.
What sorts of things?
Well, charms for luck and happiness and love.
What is the charm for love?
Yeah. I fear I've been a fearful cad.
You!
I've done nothing of the sort. You've answered the only call that counts, of love, of spring, of romance. I forgive you, Sandy, and if you love Sorrel truly, I give her to you unconditionally.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Bliss.
You can still call me Judith. Is that too much to ask?
Judith?
There now. Away with melancholy. Call me Fairy. Help me. Mother, you are splendid.
Nonsense. I just believe in being honest with myself. It's so cleansing, you know. Well, I'm going upstairs to take an aspirin.
Youth!
Youth!
What a strange, mad mother you make of things!
Did you like it?
Like it? I think it is one of the finest novels I've ever
being so nice to me. Do you have a game of plan?
So suspicious you are.
Well, I can't help it. You're very attractive. And I'm always suspicious of attractive people. You. Or you. On principle.
Oh, that's not a very good principle.
I'll tell you something, just between ourselves.
Oh, please do.
You're wrong about me.
Wrong? In what way?
I write very bad novels.
Don't be so ridiculous.
And you know I do, because you're an intelligent person.
I think nothing of the sort.
Tell me why you're being so nice.
Because I want to be.
Why?
Well, because you're a very clever and amusing man.
Splendid.
And I think I've rather lost my heart to you.
Shall we elope?
David!
There, now you call me Dick.
Well, do you mind? Well, now I don't think you're being very kind.
What makes you say that?
Well, you're being the typical author, laughing up your sleeve at a gushing admirer.
You're a very interesting woman and extremely nice.
Do you?
Yes. Would you like me to make love to you?
Really? I wish you wouldn't say such things.
Oh, you're magnificent. You're tawny.
I'm not tawny.
Don't get on.
Well, this is sheer affectation.
Yes, but affectation's very nice.
No, it isn't. It's odious. It's literary.
Well, you mustn't be cross.
Well, I'm not the least bit cross.
Yes, you are. But you're very alluring.
Alluring? Really?
Terrible.
I can hear your brain clicking. It's very funny.
That's rather rude.
You've been consistently rude to me for hours.
For mine.
Why have you?
I'm always rude to people I like.
You like me?
Enormous.
I speak you.
But I don't like your methods.
Methods? What methods?
You're far too pleasant to occupy yourself with commonplace.
Oh, and you spoil yourself trying to be clever.
But
anyhow, I don't know what you mean by commonplace.
You want me to explain what I mean?
No, not at all.
Well, I think I shall.
Well, I shan't listen.
Oh, you'll pretend not to, but you'll hear every word.
Oh, you're so inscrutable and quizzical, just as a feminine psychologist should be.
Yes, aren't I?
You frighten me dreadfully.
Darling.
Don't call me darling.
It's ridiculous. You've been wanting me to call you darling all evening.
Conceit is outrageous.
Oh, it's not conceit. You've been firmly buttering me up because you want a nice little injury.
How dare you?
You know it's true. You wouldn't be so angry.
I think you're insufferable.
Oh, Myra. Dear Myra.
Don't touch me.
Let's have that nice little intrigue. The only reason I've been so troubling is because I love to see things the way they are first, and then pretend that what they're not.
Words. Masses and masses of words.
Yes, but they're such fun to play with.
Oh, I'm glad you think so. Personally, they bore me silly.
Oh, Myra. Don't be so statuesque.
Let go of my hand.
Oh, you're charming.
Let go of my hand.
I won't.
You will.
Oh. For that, my dear, you'll be kissed.
Oh,
sweet, perfectly sweet.
Oh, David.
You must say, it's an amazing amusement. More.
Forgive me for interrupting.
Oh, are there any chocolates in the house?
Is to remain
that way. Just that way!
Rather tragic, but inevitable. I am growing old now, and
men don't grow old in the same way that women do, as you'll find to your cost, Myra, in a year or two.
Well, this is all ridiculous hysteria.
Myra, Judith is right. What are we to do?
Do? Nothing.
Do you love her truly, David?
Madly.
David?
Luke, you thought I was just joking. Couldn't you see my flippancy was just a mask, hiding my real emotions, brushing them down desperately?
I feel the time has come for a dividing of the ways.
What on earth do you mean?
I mean that I am not the sort of woman to hold a man against his will.
Judith, David doesn't love me madly, and I certainly do not love him.
You do!
I can see it in your eyes and your every gesture. David, if you love her truly, I give you to her unconditionally. We must all be good friends always.
Do you really mean this, Julie?
You know I do.
Well, how will we ever repay you?
Just by being happy.
What about the children?
Oh, really?
We shall share them, dear.
I will give you half of all my royalties, everything I receive.
That's very generous of you.
Oh, you've been magnificent. Look at you in this crisis in our lives, and thanks to you.
Judith, I will speak.
Control of our emotions. A scene right now would be agonizing for her. Look at her. She's been brave and absolutely splendid. This time, Miss Harder, let's go in the garden.
I will not go in the garden.
Please go.
I don't think that I can bear any more justice.
This is the end, Judith.
Yes, my dear. The end.
Mother! I have some amazing news to tell you.
Yes, my dear. What is it?
Where is Sorrel?
In the library, I'm afraid.
Sorrel!
Yes?
I have some vitally important news to tell you. What is it, my boy? You seem very excited.
Yes. Well, on earth's the matter?
Don't look all depressed. It's actually good news.
Good news? I thought perhaps Jackie would have drowned.
She didn't drown. She's something else.
Simon, what do you mean?
Jackie! Yes. Jackie! Come on in, Jackie!
Simon, hi!
Everyone, Jackie has wonderful news. Jackie has become engaged to me.
Oh, Simon! Oh, Simon, my dear! This is too much!
Mother, why are you crying?
All my chicks leaving the nest, soon I shall have nothing but my memories. Oh, Jackie, you must kiss me and promise to make my son very happy.
Oh, but then we just go.
Oh, you're just trying to spare my feelings, I know.
Oh, I am not trying to spare your feelings or anyone else's. This house is a feather bed of false emotions. You're posing, self-centered, egoist. A lot of you.
Myra!
Don't speak to me. I've been trying to say something all night, only every time I open my mouth, I'm mowed down by theatrical effects. There's not a single genuine or sincere feeling among a lot of you. It's artificial to the point of lunacy. It's a great pity you ever left the stage, Judith. You grateful home. You can rant and roar there as much as you like.
Rant and roar!
May you be forgiven.
I'm not
poor mite when she realizes her mother...
No, no, don't say it! I've given you everything that matters. My youth, my womanhood, my child! Will you take it all away from me? I'll have nothing left! Where am I to turn for help?
Is it true? Answer me, you cur!
Don't try to be your mother!
Mother, I think you've gone a bit too far.
Has she fainted?
Well, isn't she lucky?
You're gonna be crazy. One
Good morning, Richard.
Myra!
Good morning.
Are we the first ones down?
No, I don't think so. Some things have been moved around the table here.
Isn't this rain miserable?
Appalling.
Can I pour you some coffee?
Yes, please.
Have you seen anybody?
No! No.
Good, we might have a little bit of peace.
Have you ever stayed here before?
No, and I never will again.
You're far from well this morning.
I'm sorry, but I'm not very surprised.
Was assigned to sleep in the boiler room!
Oh, how terrible!
It was utter hell! The windows were stuck! I nearly suffocated! And the pipes made peculiar noises all night long! And the whole family have breakfast in bed?
I neither know nor care. What was that? It
came from the library, I think.
What in God's name was that?
It's someone in the library, I think, Chester.
Let's have a look. What the earth are you doing?
Hello. Good morning. It looks like you've broken a cup.
And was there anything in the cup?
Quite a bit, I'm afraid.
Let me see. Yes, it's quite a mess. Ah, and that cup.
It's my fault.
You don't say. Shocking. How did it happen?
You see, he had the hiccup, so I was trying to drink, tell our teacher how to drink. Just, you know, upside down.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Wasn't another of the crown porcelain?
Well, at least my hiccups are gone.
Oh, good.
It was a sudden shock, I expect.
Mrs. Arendelle, what do you plan to do about today?
Nothing except get out of here on the first train possible.
May I come with you? I don't think I could face another day like yesterday.
Oh, neither could I.
Let's all go away very quietly.
Wouldn't it seem a bit rude if we all left together?
Yes, it would. You must stay with Miss Corriton, Mr. Tyrell.
I don't think they'd mind much. Listen, Miss Corriton, I'll get my car, you get your things, we're out of here.
Oh, all right, but you have a car, haven't you?
Well, yes.
Will it hold all of us?
You said it would be rude for all four of us to get. You and Mr. Gretham should take the train.
If there's room, we should all be very grateful.
Well, I suppose we can squeeze in.
Great, that's settled then.
When shall we go?
As soon as you're met.
Oh, come, Jackie. Let's finish our packing.
Don't leave me here. I'll protect the car. Will you be ready in 5 minutes?
Yes, 5 minutes.